The campaign targets 40 schools, health facilities and over 50,000 natural tree species will be planted in the city. According to the Assistant Commissioner, Isaac Atwesije, the ministry is working with non-state actors to restore the degraded forest cover.
I wrote to APSA and they responded positively to make sure that our target was to see whether we can plant about 1 million trees. And we have started now and for the next 3 years. And we believe that this is going to help our city. First of all, we need where people can relax from. We need medicinal trees. So we are going to plant different, and we are starting with our secondary and primary schools and tertiary institutions and health centers within our city.
The Hoima City Mayor says the developments in the city have led to the cutting down of most of the trees, and the campaign is meant to restore all of them, starting in schools and health centers in the city. Mechanisms to monitor the planted trees have also been put in place.
First of all, the wise said we are going to put tree ambassadors in schools, in health centers, the staff of the school, and also train and encourage our children in schools to know and value these trees. But secondly, when we are going to go on the roadside, we are going to make sure the household or the owner of the property where we put the tree on next to the road, they own that tree. They don't look it as a tree for the mayor. They don't look at the tree for APSA, but they look at their own. They look at those trees as their own for their environment and for their protection as well. So we are going to make sure we are running a campaign to make sure people own the trees. They don't look at the trees being owned by the mayor or maybe owned by APSA or Hostlight, which we have partnered with to make sure that this is a reality.
The activity has been supported by Absa Bank and Helen Basuta Nangozi. The Director of Marketing and Customer Experience explains that the discovery of oil in the region has led to the rapid population increase in Hoima City, hence the pressure on the environment and other resources.
Hoima is a booming city. The population has grown over the years, especially with the discovery of oil. Today, Hoima City is averaging over 500,000 people. As population grows, so does the pressure on resources and the environment. So we have partnered with Hostlight to make sure that we can keep Hoima City green. And today we'll be planting over 50,000 trees across 33 primary schools, 4 tertiary institutions, 8 secondary schools, and also the health centers. The health centers will receive medicinal trees, whereas the schools will be planting indigenous trees and fruit trees to be able to help the children grow up environmentally conscious.
The public has been urged to maintain the current tree cover and participate in the tree planting activities.
Well, it's not entirely true that we're not doing anything. Actually, the reason we are here today is to challenge everyone, because forest loss or degradation is our own doing as individuals. It begins with you and me. If you can do something about it, then everyone else can do something about it, and the collective or cumulative effort will get us to where we want to be. And that said, we have of course there is a regulatory framework, but of course whereas you have the laws and you have the enforcement, you cannot police every tree, but it's important to create that awareness, to create a population that is responsive, that is self-regulating, such that you don't need to be there for them to do the correct thing.
The government intends to replace 2.5 million hectares of the degraded forest land across the country under the Bond Challenge, which was agreed upon by the world leaders. And Uganda's pledge was made by President Yoweri Kaguta Museveni to the United Nations General Assembly, and it became part of the New York Declaration.
Because there have also been in this campaign.
Story compiled by Godfrey Humza for the news.